sorry, experience life in the fourth and fifth dimension, did you say?
他說如果我們能夠適應四度空間和五度空間,那又怎樣?
So, sorry, if you can survive, can you understand?
He was asking if you're able to survive in the fourth or the fifth dimension, does it mean a transcendence?
是不是等於開悟,如果能夠適應?
No!
跳出荧光屏之,
you have to step outside.
现在是这样, 他的问题等于, 并不是三道空间的电视台, 我们看到, 当我们看到四度空间的电视, 五度空间的电视画面, 则开悟, 不是, 凡是看到电视画面, 都是不开悟, 要跳离荧光屏, 出来, 看到荧光屏的影像跟荧光屏的功能跟荧光屏，那么一块看，三个一块看，荧光屏功能影像，这样来看才是开悟。
The question has to do with the puzzle that if we are able to live beyond this three-dimensional realm, let's say in the fourth or the fifth dimension, does it mean that we are in any way spiritually transcendent? And the answer from Master Tam is an absolute no. Okay? The reason being that it's not in any way a process of enlightenment. Okay? Enlightenment, as discussed earlier, means that you're able to go completely beyond this manifestation on in any way. So third dimension, fifth dimension, and so forth, they're just like different channels on a TV screen. Think about the reason 3D movies, which I really hate, that really give you anything more. It's just as illusory.
But the important thing has to do with you still have, these are still images on TV screen, so you have to realize that, as well as the TV screen and the function, everything as one. If you realize that, then by definition it's enlightenment.
Yeah,
can you come up and speak up?
Consciousness，因为我理解的佛家轮回就是一个精神和一个物质上的转换，比如说我们在生的时候可能是有物质的，死了之后呢进入轮就进入或者跳开，像enlightenment开悟也是，就是转到一种纯的精神状态，再换自然就不会再处凡世间的这些东西。我想说，是不是最初你要跳出来，就是enlightenment，就是说一个无始的状态。
Sorry, very quickly to translate, see if I'm translating correctly. So the question was, the realm of the Buddha, does that mean is there still consciousness?
His understanding is that the attainment of Buddhahood is about transcending all forms of existence, so that you become formless, just existing in a spiritual way. Am I understanding correctly? So, if that were the understanding, the question comes: is the state of enlightenment still has, the consciousness aspect or not?
我能补充一下吗？ 因为刚才说TV screen 是不是？ 我想是不是我理解的就是说，一切都在 TV screen 里面，所以说所谓的精神，或者是物质，其实都是在影像，就是在 TV 上那种影像，本身这都是一个凡世间才存在的东西，但是我没有到这个框，我觉得这也是我的问题。
好。 在银光屏里边的世界，当然只有就有两种了，一个是精神，一个是物质的。这个精神方面，我们是就是做思，思不只是意识，言语、生意等等等等。
So there's the abstract aspect of the mind is not only just strictly consciousness of the mind. There's also the abstract or the spiritual side.
在物质方面，我们在荧光屏来看荧光屏，就说物质是有的。
So within the TV screen, we may say there are physical things within the TV screen. They physically exist.
我们说有的意思就是说尽存在也显现，又存在又显现，所以是有了。
One thinking of existence you can think of as both they actually physically exist and also there's a manifestation.
在精神方面，我们说心思是可以拿来分别的，所以因此它从庞大的功能它也成为有了。
So,
分别的功能。
In terms of the abstract side, there's.
So there are. Let me recap a little bit. On the manifestation on a TV screen, there are actually two aspects about that. One is matter, and the other is mind. Okay. So in terms of physical matters, we can speak of them as existence because they both have a presence. And they have this manifestation. And about the aspect of mind, we call our mind exists because of this ability to cognize, to differentiate things.
那么成佛有没有离开这个世界呢？他的问题主要是等于问这个了。
So, it boils down to the question.Does Buddhahood, attaining Buddha, mean that we have to leave behind all these?
拿释迦牟尼来讲，他成佛了。他成佛就证到一个字，那个字就等于怎么样？是你能够离开荧光屏来看荧光屏，荧光屏功德跟荧光屏影像，他认识了。他认识的我们叫实相。
So take the historical Buddha as an example.
叫真如了。
When he attained his enlightenment, what he actually realized is a state of mind, a wisdom that allows him to view the world outside of it, to be able to see that there is this foundation that allows, images or that allows things to appear, the function of this foundation, in a holistic aspect. That's what he realized. And this realization is called the reality or simply thusness.
他是用什么来看？是用意识来看，还是用他的智来看？
So how does he view the world?Did he use his so-called mind or consciousness, or did he use the wisdom to see the world?
那么就要晓得佛家是怎么讲的了。
And we have to understand this question from the perspective of the Buddhist teachings.
我首先成佛时候证的智，我们把它叫做根本智。
So when someone attains Buddhahood, the wisdom attained is known as the primordial wisdom or the fundamental wisdom, innate wisdom.
你不能叫做 root wisdom.
The root wisdom.
可是同时他就生一个厚德智了。
But at the same time of having this root wisdom,
记得是同时。
At the same time, there is this subsequent wisdom that goes along with it.
那么解 他看我们这个世间的慈相，这是靠后的字来看。
So the understanding or the viewing of this world is through this subsequent wisdom, on the basis of the root of wisdom.
也就是说，释迦牟尼成佛以后，还在我们这个世界生活，他是靠什么字来生活？这是靠后的字。
So when the historical Buddha Shakyamuni attained his Buddhahood, he was still living in our world.In this world, but you know, 2500 years ago.
现在你可
and he was seeing the world through this subsequent attained wisdom.
你可能会回问，意思跟后的字有什么不同？
So you might wonder what's the difference between consciousness, you know, and this subsequent wisdom.
这牵涉到一个问题了，这个问题很要紧。意思是干什么来？我们其实是按名言与概念来意识运作的。
So this comes to a really crucial understanding that distinguishes the two. Our mind, our consciousness functions on the basis of language and concepts.
我们从来没看过一个原子、一个分子，可是我们都晓得有原子与分子。那是靠什么？靠名言与概念。
So none of us has ever seen a molecule or an atom, but we can still talk about them, you know, to distinguish them. It only because we are relying on language and concepts.
所以这个叫名言有了。
So atoms and molecules exist through our, you know.
Language and the concept. 后的字是应用名言，还是同我们用同一的语言与其实不是，这是离道名言与概念去理解而成立的一个相，也就是没有分别的相。我们按名言与句意就有分别了，不按这个名言与句意去理解这个事就没有分别了。
Through the subsequent wisdom, verbally, you know, a Buddha, an enlightened being, can still make use of the language.But the way they see the world is not on the basis of language and concepts. In other words, they are able to see the world in a way that is not limited by our conceptual ideas. They penetrate through our language and concepts to arrive at an, you know, intuitive understanding of how things really are.
好了，理解没有啊？
是非常清楚。
啊，哪里哪里。